Jim Keehan there of BlackRock, where he oversees $28 billion. You look like you're chomping at the bit here.
I hate this segment here. look, high-yield bonds make a terrible investment for Main Street investors. They have extremely high volatility, and they're poor diversifiers in your portfolio, meaning their standard deviation can be as high as 15 or 20, very similar to stocks. And when stocks crash, like you saw in 2008 and 2009, those high-yield bonds crash with it. So bad diversifier, bad overall in your portfolio. I wouldn't have them.
So, but you can't, where do you go for yield? First of all, do you agree or disagree, Nick?
I think high yield's a very crowded trade. I disagree that they're a bad asset class all the time, but I do think they're very crowded here.
What do you think that investors should do for yield if they don't go to high yield? Do they just have to accept a lower yield of safer corporate debt?
Well, this whole thing about investing for yield is just a big myth propagated on investors. They should be managing their money for overall long-term return with the volatility they're accepting. So my investors don't care whether it comes from yield or whether it comes from growth in the underlying stock. So the trick is to make the right combination of a short-term fixed income against the volatile equity so that you can rebalance on highs and lows. If you do that, you don't need high-yield bonds.
How do you, by the way, pick out equities if you're looking for the long-term? Do you just go after index funds?
We've used something called structured funds that try to capture a market dimension, but not index funds because those are very generic. For example, studies show that over the last 30 years, you can get added an additional 3 to 4% with micro caps and another 3 to 4 with high book-to-market value stocks. So it's very hard to get a regular index that would track that. And then we diversify that internationally with emerging markets and then a global portfolio.
But it's hard, Nick. It's hard to pick stocks in this market, right? Otherwise, that's why we see such low volume. That's why we see no movement. Everyone seems paralyzed.
Yeah, it's very tough because if you look over the past year or so, correlations have been generally very, very high. So a lot of asset classes act very similar. Even things like gold and stocks, which historically are very diverse, haven't really provided any diversification. We've seen those correlations crack in the past couple of months, which is great to see, but we've seen it come along with this very low volume, which makes it feel like a very, very low conviction trade.
Right. Zero Hedge tweeted the correlation yesterday between oil and cyclicals. I retweeted it. You can check that out on my Twitter at MattMiller1973. Quick break, and we're back with the richest men and women in the world. Stay with us.